Welcome to St. Mary's Harefield's Thought for the Day for Monday the 1st of June. Our opening hymn is a bit controversial because of William Blake's unconventional views, but it roots us in England's green and pleasant land, and it mentions building Jerusalem in our context and in our time. You'll see in just a moment how appropriate that is for our theme today. And did those feet in ancient time walk upon England's mountains green? And was the Holy Lamb of God on England's pleasant pastures seen? And did the countenance divine shine forth upon our clouded hills? And was Jerusalem builded here among those dark, satanic mills? I will not cease from mental fight, nor shall my sword sleep in my hand, till we have built Jerusalem in England's green and pleasant land. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we seek your blessing today upon the place where we live, which sustains our lives and to which we contribute. Amen. This week we'll conclude our look at various people we encounter in Matthew's Gospel. Today we're considering the people of Jerusalem, a very varied bunch. Jesus is able to summarise the city and its people in a particular respect. Matthew chapter 23, verses 37 to 39, Jesus grieves over Jerusalem. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you who kill the prophets and stone those sent to you. How often I have longed to gather your children together, as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, and you were not willing. Look, your house is left to you, desolate. For I tell you, you will not see me again until you say, Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. There's often a particular ethos or spirit connected to a place, a city or an area or a nation. It's always a broad brush identification to try and define London or Australia or Wales or Harefield in a certain way. But it is possible to do this. Locations do have their characteristics, despite differences between the range of people they contain. Jerusalem, for me, has a magical quality about it. I've been there a few times. The golden colour of its stone, its rich history of faith, its fascinating buildings, its sunshine and warm climate, its diversity of peoples, and usually its creative hustle and bustle. I can't picture Jerusalem being in lockdown. Jesus, though, labels the city differently, as a rebellious place, one that has consistently failed to listen to God. Rather, it's rejected any critical comment. It now refuses to accept Jesus too. Jesus would love to give it protection, as a mother hen would do for her chicks. He longs to embrace its people, but it's just not happening. So desolation is on the cards. There are a couple of things we might helpfully consider today. Firstly, it's location, location, location. Where we are, where we live, maybe where we are today in lockdown, has a certain characteristic that is helpful to identify. It's just the way it is. Harefield, where I've now lived on and off for about 16 years, has a village sense of community about it. Many people really miss being able to meet together at the moment. They'll be glad when this is slightly changing today, although also slightly fearful of how to embrace this change. Of course, the village has changed itself over the years. It's grown in population. There are some who choose not to be part of its communal life. There are those who miss out by default. It's spread out geographically, so it depends which part of it we live in. But having said all this, it does have a real sense of community that other places within London, for example, don't naturally have. So to make the most of being where we are, it's helpful to take this on board. It is what it is. By the way, for us who live in Harefield, we are in many ways very blessed with great natural beauty on our doorstep and a world-ranking hospital at its centre. The other thing to consider is that things can always become better. This is evolutionary thinking rather than analytical thinking. Places can become better, people can become better, everything can become better. Things don't even have to be bad in the first place to become better. A place can live up to its best characteristic. It can increase in the good things that are there anyway, and can be strong anyway. This can be a challenge, of course, particularly if we become too comfortable. Good can be the enemy of the best. In the late 19th century, there was an evolutionary optimism around, but it was a false one. It was based on human achievement, and it didn't survive the wars and challenges of the 20th century. For the world to advance then and now, God, its creator, needs to be involved. Jesus identifies this spiritual problem at the heart of Jerusalem in his day. It does not turn to God, it turns away from God. So there is something wrong, but it can be remedied and can become better. Jesus would love to enable this to happen, to gather its people together as a mother hen gathers her chicks under her wings. Jesus is not writing Jerusalem off. In fact, at the end of the Bible story is the new Jerusalem, not the rebellious one, where God is at the centre. And we pray today for the peace of the Jerusalem that we know. Its name means City of Peace. So can we identify today, in our situation, something about where we are and the nature of life that we're experiencing, the characteristic of our location? And can we then pray and direct our energies and intentions to make it better and better and better again? By your side I would stay. In your arms I would lay, Jesus, lover of my soul. Nothing from you I withhold. Lord, I love you and adore you. What more can I say? You cause my love to grow stronger with every passing day.
Thank you.
We pray for the easing of lockdown, which is planned to take effect today, especially the partial opening of schools. We pray for God's blessing on the place where we live. We pray for the peace and blessing of Jerusalem, which means City of Peace, today. We pray for our farmers affected by so much at the present time, including the lack of rain for the crops and pasture. We continue to pray for those who are ill today to experience God's healing touch, especially baby Maisie, who is doing very well, Astrid, Barbara Leek, Bob Warner, Ellis, Jarlith O'Connell, also doing well, Jean Green, Nicola McKinnon, Norman Harker, Roy Harris, Peter Clare, Claire, and any others we know. And we pray too for those who grieve the loss of loved ones, for comfort, for those people who will miss Olive Newstead, Helen Jones, Susan Dell, Alastair, Diane Scanlon, Marjorie Evans, and any others known to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Thinking of that picture that Jesus gives us of a hen gathering her chicks under her wings for protection, we pray that we may place ourselves under the protection and guidance of the Good Shepherd today. Loving Shepherd of thy sheep, keep thy lamb in safety keep. Nothing can thy power withstand, none can pluck me from thy hand. Loving Shepherd, ever near, teach thy lamb thy voice to hear. Suffer not my steps to stray from the straight and narrow way. Where thou leadest, I would go, walking in thy steps below. Then before my Father's throne, I shall know as I am known. Lord, help us today to seek the blessing of the place that sustains us, to contribute to the well-being of others, to turn to you for direction in this new week and new month, and to share your grace and your love with others. And may the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you and those you love today and always. Amen.